They revolutionized how you control your stream once before, and now they're doing it again.
Whoa, so cool!
The Elgato Stream Deck Plus.
Not my dials! I can get a hype train!
Because buttons are no longer good enough.
Elgato reinvented the Stream Deck. You've got dials, a touchscreen, 8 beefy screen-backed buttons. There's a lot of careful consideration here in some ways, but then a continued lack of it in others. I'm your stream professor. Let's take a closer look.
This video is sponsored by CuriosityStream. Get access to my own streaming site, Nebula, and watch my exclusive documentary series premiering on November 21st with the bundle linked below. The Stream Deck is a control device to allow you to control OBS Studio, Windows, macOS, or any other program through tight software integrations or external hotkeys. You can do anything from switching scenes on stream to turning on all the lights for your setup and changing their color temperature to managing program volume, monitor system stats, play games, or make them. There's a fair bit of existing integrations baked into the device. Into the software for the device. Not much is in here, especially if you are already in the Elgato ecosystem of peripherals, such as their webcams, their lights, their capture cards, and so on. And they have a pretty healthy plugin hub built in to download third-party plugins to work with other programs and utilities, or play mini games, even. Plus, services like Slideshow FX make full shortcut and icon kits for programs like DaVinci Resolve and Adobe Premiere Pro to help you get set up quickly with macros. And then there's the Bitfocus Companion mod for Stream Deck that allows it to work with broadcasts and other industry gear instead of just consumer devices, which is pretty cool. We've had multiple iterations of this concept for a while now, some with more buttons, some with fewer buttons, some with removable stands, some with faceplates, but it's all been the same concept of a panel with a bunch of buttons. Elgato's facing steep competition from the likes of LoopDeck and Mountain Now, plus DIY solutions like Touch Portal and Touch OSC. Demand for alternative control methods and more unique types of control has increased, plus the constant expectation that there will be a pro Wave XLR that's more like the Go XLR. This is what Elgato came up with, the Stream Deck Plus. I think it answers most of those requests. Kinda. Alternative control methods? Check. 4 dials line the front and provide clicky, tactile rotation, and button presses. These give a bunch of options in the software. Using the integration, you can do awesome stuff like adjust program volume levels in Windows and now macOS with their new audio engine, control zooming and panning of your Elgato webcam or your phone webcam linked through their Epoch Cam app, which is now supported in Camera Hub, change light brightness, and so on. The program volume control is actually a new Stream Deck plugin from Elgato directly that will release with version 6 and works with all Stream Deck devices, not just the SD Plus. Nice. While the primary program audio control they give you is great, the Stream Deck Plus also lets you use the Wavelink software with or without a Wave Audio device. Y'all have been asking for them to do a standalone release for this software since the first Wave released, and while they haven't done that, this is the next best thing. At least for those wanting to get this device. Wavelink establishes a bunch of virtual audio devices on Windows. On Mac, it just lets you control program audio and things like that to let you map programs to and then mix with the real audio devices present on your computer without needing a beefy audio mixer like I do at my main desk. That way, you can control everything separately and you can do things like record your game sound and Discord voice chat on separate tracks, remove music altogether, that kind of thing. This is an immediate boon to my setup and works a little bit more fluidly than my previous strategy of controlling the Wavelink devices separately with the PC Panel Pro. Still a great device, but a little more clunky than this native integration. Tapping in the dials allows you to mute audio devices or turn off the lights if you're controlling them there. The touchscreen above the dials provides real-time information about what the dials are doing. Volume levels, as I'm adjusting that here, you've got brightness levels for your lights, mute status, and so on. Or if I swipe over to my camera page, I can start zooming in and it shows me that information in real time as I zoom in and out, pan and tilt it around, adjust my exposure compensation. Very handy. You can also tap or touch the touchscreen part on those dial actions to do certain things too, like muting the audio device. Unfortunately, you can't currently map independent touch actions to the screen separate from whatever is the default for what your dials are already assigned to do. You can customize the background of the whole touch bar and the background of each action's quadrant. Click right here in the little thing. You can go over here to icons for the individual actions, and you can right click and set from file or open up the background library to adjust background for the entire quadrant itself. Get some lovely little themes going on here. Really dig these. I think these are Mac specific on this one. You can also come in here to adjust the new background specifically for each individual action from a file as well. Swiping left or right on the touchscreen allows you to swipe through pages of button and dial actions, making it a really expansive way to add more controls to your fingertips without needing more devices. Being able to not just control device volume, but do other things on the system is exactly what many, many of us were asking for the Beacon Mix Create to be able to do, and they never delivered. Well, Elgato has. I feel like some other clever additional uses for the dials are missing, and hopefully whenever the plugin SDK for these new tools rolls out to plugin developers, we'll see the likes of BarRater implementing them. I'm imagining you can use the dials to control, say, the OBS Move plugin to move sources around in real time with, you know, stepping setups on your canvas, move actual, you know, windows and actual windows around using the window resizer, and so on. If all of that control wasn't enough, you can manually assign hotkeys to clockwise, counterclockwise, and tapping of the dials to do even more unique actions or to just do whatever you want. Theoretically, this is how you'd be able to control apps like, say, Adobe Photoshop, Adobe Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve for brush sizes, transform settings, and so on. Akin to the Palette Gear or the Monogram console devices, as demonstrated in these test profiles that Slideshow FX sent over for testing, which is rad, but you currently have no control over the stepping amount for rotations on the hotkeys like you do for the volume and brightness sliders and controls like that, which could be a problem, as Taryn frequently ranted about during his reviews of such devices. It's a wonderful feature, don't get me wrong, but you will need to be able to give more control in the long run. Even cooler is the dial stack. These profiles demonstrate this feature well. Dial stacks are an incredibly considerate feature that allow you to stack a bunch of different actions on a specific dial and then tap to cycle between them. So for controlling a brush, for example, in Photoshop, you can tap the dial to swap between brush size, brush angle, feathering, and flow to adjust all of these on a single dial, or just brush, rather than to use up multiple dials and a bunch of pages, as that would get really clunky really quickly. This is incredible. Expansion could always be extended further with the likes of Streamer.bot and Atom as well. Overall, this device is incredibly considerate for what most users might want to do, at least on the software side. On the physical side, however, things are a different story. As has regularly been the case with recent Elgato products, there seems to be virtually zero considerations given to how a user might want to use this device outside of Elgato's assumed workflow. The original Stream Deck, this one, came with an adjustable stand. It was a little floppy, but it lets you get the exact angle that you wanted, or remove it and use it flat on the surface. I loved that. All future Stream Decks came with static, unchanging stands that could at least be removed, but only at a specific angle. Now we're on the fifth Elgato Stream Deck device, and Elgato have seemingly done nothing to address the serious demand for mounting options. Quarter 20 threaded tap for friction arms, or a first party clamp to use it, or something. Thankfully, I know a good place that you can get custom mounting clamps for cheap at the link below, tuned specifically for Stream Decks. Now, the Stream Deck Plus kind of might enable this, as its stand screws into the bottom of the device. Remove these two screws to lay it flat. Theoretically, this would also be a somewhat easy point to screw attach a 3D printed mount and hold onto it more securely instead of relying on friction. But the screws are in an awkward place, like right here at the bottom edge, and they are really tiny. An industry standard quarter 20 tap would go a long way to addressing this and letting the user use literally whatever they want to mount it without having to deal with extra solutions. The buttons on this model are bigger than any previous Stream Deck iteration, like really big, with fewer of them compared to the standard 15 or the XL32 key models, which makes them easier to see and easier to reach, which is nice, but it highlights just how mushy they feel. It really does not feel good to push these buttons, especially after using the Mountain's clicky display pad. The USB is removable here on the back though. This new Stream Deck is also missing a big thing that Elgato introduced with the Stream Deck 2 and the Wave XLR, faceplates. These devices came with removable faceplates that admittedly feel like you're breaking them to take off, but then you could customize and make your own. or buy a unique pattern one from the Corsair website. I kept pushing my Elgato contacts for them to sell a pack of blanks for artists to buy and then customize and sell in their shops, but I don't think this ever happened. The Stream Deck Plus does not have a removable faceplate. The trend is already dead. This does not reasonably come off, and you would have to take the knobs off for everything like that. They will be selling models with uniquely colored knobs, starting with gold and silver, starting at the beginning of next year. Well, that's it for customizability. Where are my faceplates? Stream Deck Plus costs $200. That's the price you can get the Stream Deck XL for at Best Buy and B&H at the time of writing, sitting about $50 more than the normal Stream Deck. It's expensive, but I think for the extra controls that you're getting, that's probably a good place for this to land price-wise. $200 for this kind of thing ain't bad, especially when the actual broadcast controllers for this kind of setup run significantly more expensive. It's fewer buttons than the base Stream Deck and the XL, which people are certainly gonna meme on, as they often do with Elgato pricing and things like that, but the dial stacks and the swipeable pages via the touch bar will make that a non-issue for me personally. I know once I find a way to mount this thing, I will be swapping it out and swapping my main XL out for it as my main controller moving forward. If the Stream Deck is a new concept to you, don't throw $200 at the screen yet. Download Touch Portal, or the free trial of Stream Deck over on mobile to use your tablet or smartphone as a Stream Deck to control your software, to learn the ins and outs, get a feel for, you know, how it might apply to your setting. While Elgato has put a ton of time into making the software accessible and user-friendly, it can be daunting to see a blank canvas when you first set it up and not know where to start. Trying out the free version lets you figure out how it works and whether it's actually worth investing in for, you know, your money, that kind of thing. To help you get started with Stream Deck, if you already have one or you're trying out the free stuff, my Nebula subscribers will get access to a full pre-built profile with a bunch of sample actions that you can do as a demo. The OBS scenes would need to be linked up to your own OBS scenes because you're gonna have a different profile than I do, so they can't work fully out of the box, but overall it will help you get an idea of the basic startup so you can build your own from there. There's also a bonus Nebula Plus companion video covering my top Stream Deck plugins to expand your actions even more than what comes by default. Nebula is my own video site I built with my creator friends, where my videos are ad-free, often extended or paired with bonus content, and earlier than YouTube Now, and now home to my exclusive series as a Nebula original print screen. Just so much content. The best way to sign up for this is with the bundle we built with CuriosityStream, another great video streaming site full of thousands of documentaries and entertaining videos from science to history to tech. While you're waiting to take a look into the past with my print screen documentary series, check out Cyborgs, Human Machines on CuriosityStream to take a peek into what the future might look like as humanity becomes more and more just merged with technology. Our bundle comes at an exclusive discount of 26% off their annual rate, making it just $14.79 for two video sites packed full of content to keep you entertained all weekend, all winter, however long you want to keep watching. You can find that at curiositystream.com/epos. Don't miss out. What features do you think Elgato should add to the Stream Deck? Are there any cooler stream controllers out there that I should cover? Comment below. Otherwise, remember to be kind, rewind. Render, how do you rate the Stream Deck Plus? How many beans?
Nope.
Zero beans. Sorry.